question.
Flex start working now?
The second way you could write a hook, you could also use an exclamation.
Class, make sure you write down those steps.
I guess it's to write.
Turn off the light.
Yeah, it's too bad.
Turn off the light, see if it'll help. What's that? Oh, no.
Yeah, leave that one.
You can turn on the light on that.
Yeah, but it's, let's just leave it as is.
Okay.
I can see it back there.
It's legible, yeah. An exclamation or feeling. Wow, that blank was amazing. I'm describing how something made me feel, and I started with a wow. That's an exclamation. So something that sounds fantastic or amazing. That was a baby on the example. And lastly, a hook, you can describe. Describe a setting. And the reason describing the setting starts in the introduction is because in every story, the first thing we introduce are our characters and our setting. So even if we're talking about a real life experience, your narrative starts with you and your setting. Make sense? So in this example, it's me at the beach getting ready to paddleboard. Remember my example?
Yes.
My first time paddleboarding? So I will describe the setting. I'm going to write the example so you remember. Warm sand between my toes. Examples. Of course, yours are going to look different when you write your hook. So as I leave you today to practice, I want you to write me an amazing hook using the details from your web thinking. Your hook should ask the reader a question or use an exclamation, or you could describe the setting. Give me a thumbs up when you're done writing about a hook. About what we learn when we are reading a story. Think about what we learn in fourth grade when we're organizing our writing in paragraphs. What comes after the hook? Xavier?
A topic.
A topic, right? You need to keep your idea focused throughout the essay, right? And we have several bubbles, right? Can we combine our bubbles into one paragraph if they're about the same thing?
Yes.
Yes. So your evidence is what you wrote in your bubble chart. So after your hook, you're going to describe the moment. So you're going to skip a line. So I'm going to actually skip a line here, because when you're writing, I want you to skip a line for your paragraph. And you are going to describe your special moment. What were the topics we used to describe our special moment? What was the first topic? The first bubble. The first main idea. All right?
Asking the
No, we're talking about a hook. When we were organizing our writing.
Feelings?
Feelings. That was one way to describe the moment, right? So you could describe your feelings. And there was one more thing, one more topic, one more main idea.
Surprise.
That's an example, but we brainstormed how we felt, and we also brainstormed something else. What did we brainstorm?
What
I brainstormed.
What you saw, using your five senses, right? So in the middle is where you slow down and start describing and taking your reader through a story, through a journey. And this is the middle of your narrative. You're describing why your moment was special. This is where all the details. Make sure if I skip a line in my notes, you also skip a line in your notes. Description has the most detail, so that's probably going to be the middle of your page, a big chunk of it. Maybe about six sentences. Your hook's usually about three. That should be your goal. Not always, but for this practice, it's going to be short and sweet. The middle is where you describe. And what are we missing? We have the B, the M. What's missing? The E. What should come at the very end? Look at your bubbles. What comes at the very end?
Big takeaway.
Your big takeaway. Good job, Xavier.
He's on the ball today.
Mm-hmm. Or explain my big takeaway. And as you can remember from fourth grade, your conclusion should tie in with your introduction. That's why they look similar in size. So as we progress through the year, we're going to be more specific into what we include in our writing. But this is a good little map to start a narrative. Describe or explain my big takeaway will be your conclusion. In other words, understory end. At the end, you're going to tell the reader what you learned. Finish up our notes so we can take a quick brain break.
This is where you're going to project it.
Yeah, well, actually, I'm recording what she's doing right now.
This is writing a narrative.